Okay guys, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys how to get this eye look done. I actually wore this in one of my past videos, and I think this had the most comments out of any other video that I've ever recorded asking what color eyeshadow I was wearing. And that was kind of surprising because I was a little bit skeptical to choose this color because it is so in your face and bright. But you guys know me, I'm not very much of a neutral type of girl. I really like using pops of colors and things like that because I do my gigs and it's just really fun to be surprising and just kind of out there. So, first things first, get all your hair out of your face because that's one thing that I like to do. I don't like to do my makeup with any hair on my face whatsoever because it's just kind of annoying. So, okay, so we're going to go ahead and prime our eyes, and you want to make sure to use whatever primer you have on hand. I am using the Mary Kay Signature Eye Primer, which looks like this right here. And just make sure you prime the top of your eyelid really well. And you also want to bring it all the way down to the waterline as well. Well, not in your waterline, but the lower lash line. That'd be crazy, right? If you had to prime your waterline, that would probably burn the crap out of your eyeball. So you just want to make sure you blend that in really well. If you don't have a primer on hand, just make sure that you do conceal and powder your eye really well. And maybe you can use a cream base, like a white shimmery cream color that you have on hand. Okay, the first color we're going to go ahead and use here is the Glamour Doll Eyeshadow in Mingles. And this is my all-time favorite color so far that I do own. So, oh my gosh, you guys, look at this color. It's gorgeous. Now, if there was an equivalent to hot pink, you know how it's pink and then there's hot pink? Well, if there was a blue and a hot blue, this would be it. It's just so gorgeous. And I'm going to go ahead and take a brush that came with my Coastal Scents palette because I really feel like it gets into my crease really well. It's just really thin and it looks like this. I'm just going to kind of tap into there, and you just want to tap the extra off onto the lid just like that. And that's pretty much all you're going to use for the entire eye. So what I like to do is I like to stick the brush right into the socket, and I'll just open my eye, and then I'll just kind of sweep that through. And you just want to blend it through all through the crease area all the way to the front, and just make sure that it's going to start off as kind of like a line like that, because we're going to go ahead and blend it later. So then you want to grab just a little bit more, and you're going to go ahead and go to the end area like this. You just kind of make like a little bit of a V shape. So usually I'll just kind of shade that in just like that. And this color does stick really well. It's not like super, super blendable, but it does blend after a while when you use another eyeshadow, which I'll show you that in just a little bit. But the color is just fabulous. This is like, I've never seen a color like this in my entire life. Not in any palettes, not in any other mineral eyeshadow, nothing like that. So I'm just going to deepen this up to the intensity that I like. And for this look, I'm going to make it very deep because I am going to be going out. And this is not something that you should wear during the day. Unless you're more daring and you like to wear this type of stuff during the day, then go for it. But this is more of a night look, or maybe even like a themed look, or, you know, maybe even for a Halloween party, if you're going to do something where you need to wear a sparkly eye, this would be perfect. So we're just going to do that. And so far, so good. It looks pretty good from there. So now the next color I'm going to take by Glamour Doll Eyes is Dirty Jeans. And it's this really pretty color. It's like a light kind of blue with like dusty goldish green undertones. So I'm going to go ahead and take my MAC. What is this? The 224 brush, just a fluffy brush that you have in hand. And I'm just going to take some from the lid, tap off the extra, and then I'm just going to go right on top of here and just kind of blend that top line together. Or blend it out, rather. Just like that. So you can see it's already smoking out really nicely. I really, really love these eyeshadows. I have seen the colors that come in like yellow and really bright neon oranges. I really want to try those. They look really interesting to me. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to use this color called Hot Mess. And this is actually a glitter. So I love glitter. I love incorporating glitter into my looks. And this is kind of like a purpley glitter. And it's got kind of like green flecks in there. It even has like bluish tones. So this is really pretty. And all you're going to need is the glitter from the lid again. So I'm going to take a synthetic brush just like this, and this one I believe is just like a cheapy brush that I had hanging around. And from Sally's Beauty Supply, they sell this, what's it called, Sparkle Effective, or Sparkle Effects Gel Adhesive for Glitter. So It looks like this is 99 cents. You can use this to apply glitter. If not, you can always use like a clear lip gloss or whatever. That'll work fine as long as it's pretty thick and not one of those runny lip glosses. So, which is usually like what I'll use if I don't have that on hand, and it sticks on just as well. So, you're just going to take a little bit of that onto your ring finger. You just need a little bit. You're just going to kind of dab it together, and then you want to dab it right onto that area where your skin is at, where there's no color. So you're just going to kind of dab it into there. And this is going to make it nice and tacky so the glitter will stick. So the next thing I'm going to do is grab my brush, and I'm going to go ahead and just kind of tap it onto my eye area where I just put that clear gloss or clear gel on. And that's going to get the brush sticky so it can pick the glitter up from here. Because if you goop some of that clear stuff onto your brush, it's going to pick way too much glitter up and it's just going to be a big mess. So now you're going to get some glitter, and as you can see, it picked up the perfect amount. And you're just going to tap it right onto that area. And it's going to start off a little bit kind of spread out, and it's not going to look too even. But after a few times, it'll even up. And you don't need to get too close to the lash line because you're going to put liquid liner on there. I keep saying a lot. I'm so sorry. I haven't done a tutorial in a while, so. So just keep doing this until you get it to where you like it and to the maximum amount that you like on your eyelids. Because I know a lot of people don't like a lot of glitter, and a lot of people do like glitter. So, but just remember that once it sets, it does kind of just blend together really nicely. So after you've applied the glitter, you're going to go ahead and go back in with the color Mingles, which was that really bright blue. And you're going to use the same brush that you used at the very beginning and just kind of go through and intensify that blue one more time. So that way you can keep that eyeshadow separated from the glitter. And it's just going to make it more defined, and it's just going to add a little more color. Just like that. So now the next thing you're going to do is you're going to use a liquid liner on the top. If you have liquid or gel, that would be something that would be preferable to use, because if you use a pencil, you're going to have to clean the pencil off from all the glitter, and usually just kind of get stuck and wedged in there, and you waste a lot of product trying to sharpen it off. So I'm going to use this felt tip eyeliner from Physicians Formula. It's a 24-hour wear, and this is a liquid liner, not a gel, Haley. And you're just going to line your eye. I'm just going to follow my natural eye shape. And I just like to kind of extend it just a little bit just to make my eyes look a little bit bigger. And also, if you have problems putting on liquid eyeliner, my biggest suggestion is to not start from the front and go to the back. Start from the back and go to the front, because you can usually make a lot a super straight line like that rather than going from the front to the back. You tend to mess up on this area and it starts getting crooked and wobbly. That's just the way I do it. I start from the back because I find that I have better control. And then you can go ahead and connect it from the front to the middle. So now that you have that finished, you're going to go ahead and get a waterproof pencil liner for your waterline right down here. I'm going to go ahead and use Rimmel's Exaggerate Waterproof Eye Definer. And I really, really, really love this eyeliner. It's my brand new favorite. And you're just going to line your waterline. Gently do that, and then you're going to go ahead and squint your eyes together, so that way you don't have to tight line, it kind of transfers to the top. And if you don't know what tight lining is lining that very top area right here underneath your eyelashes on the top. But when you squish your eyes together, it automatically just kind of transfers and smudges up there to the top. Okay, so now that we've done that, I'm going to take a brush that I'm really liking. It's from Sephora. Came with a set that I had, and it looks like this. I believe MAC is coming out with one of these, or has come out with one of these. But this is just like a really thin, blunt, flattish kind of brush. And I'm going to take that color Mingles, and I'm just going to dip my brush in there a little bit. And we're going to smudge that right at the bottom. And this is going to look really nice because it gives it like that kind of dirty blue effect. It doesn't look as bright as it does on the top. So it gives it kind of like a dirty, smoky look, which I really, really like. Kind of make sure you blend it in at the end also. So now I'm going to go ahead and curl my lashes and put some mascara on, and I'll be right back. Okay, girls. So after you, or boys, after you put the glitter on and then you've curled and put mascara on your lashes, you're going to go ahead and do some cleanup. So my tips when using glitter is, if you're a newbie to using glitter products, you may not want to put your foundation and concealer on. But in my case, I already kind of have that control where I don't get a lot of fallout. So I went ahead and put my foundation on. So now we're just going to go ahead and clean up with your concealer. Or if you didn't put your foundation on, this is where you would do so. Also, if you do have fallout on your face, you can just take some scotch tape and stick it to the back of your hand like once or twice. And then just pick up all that little extra glitter on your face. And the reason you want to stick it to the back of your hand is so that way it's not tugging at your eye area. It's just going to pick those little flecks of glitter up that are just annoying and look messy. Because there's nothing worse than having a really beautiful, glittery, dramatic eye and then tons of glitter down here. I've seen girls like that. So I'm just going to dab a bit of concealer under my eyes. And I'm using the Double Wear Stay in Place Concealer from Estee Lauder. I'm going to take a foundation brush and I'm just going to go ahead and clean this area up. And this is something that I do every day, no matter what eye look I do, because I just feel like it brightens up the area, it cleans everything up nicely, so it makes your eyes just really pop and stand out. So you really want to get into that inner corner. And there you go. We're all done. So I'm going to go ahead and finish this off with a nice, kind of a light pinky peachy color, just a light wash of blush, and then I'm going to use a baby pink cream color lipstick. So you can use a nude or a really baby pink, but nothing with shimmer, because since your eyes already have shimmer, you don't want to look like a big old disco ball. So again, if you guys are interested in these colors, we used the color Mingles, which was that cobalt bluish color. We used Hot Mess, which was that really pretty glittery color. And then we used Dirty Jeans, which was a really nice blue color, a very light baby bluish goldish color. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoy this tutorial. I will be doing more using Glamour Doll Eyes products because I really, really like them a lot and they're just gorgeous. And I do also have another line of tutorials coming up for you guys, which I'm so excited about. So I guess I'll see you guys later. Love you. Bye-bye.